Now we are going to see the procedure for drawing cam profile for uniform acceleration and retardation. Here, suppose the given information is like this. Length of the stroke is 40 mm and rise is 120 degrees, dwell is 30 degrees and fall is 120 degrees. So for the length of the stroke of the, this is for length of the stroke of the follower, 40 mm given. So draw y-axis that is equals to 40 mm, that is the length of the stroke of the follower. And first of all, and draw the x-axis with some unknown length, and on that x-axis we have to mark rise, dwell, fall. To mark this rise, dwell, fall, these are given in angles, so the convert that into linear dimensions and mark on the x-axis. So well, if you do like this, this diagram is called displacement diagram. From the displacement diagram we will draw the cam profile. So here first of all convert this angles rotated by this cam into linear dimensions. For that we have to take some scale. So that is, suppose if I take 1 centimeter is equals to 20 degrees, so this rise can be represented by 6 centimeters. So here suppose we start here, it is 0, and to represent rise start from 0 and mark on this x-axis as 6 centimeters, because we have taken scale 1 centimeter is equals to 20 degrees. So that will be 120 degrees, means we have to represent here 6 centimeters. So represent 6 centimeters. So this will indicate the rise. After that you indicate dwell. So dwell will be, it is 1.5 centimeters according to this scale. So indicate 1.5 centimeters. So that will indicate the dwell. And after that indicate this fall, and that will be same as 6 centimeters. So this is the for given examples. So we will get like this. And here if you see what is the rise, means when the cam and follower are rotating, the rise means that the period the angle rotated by this cam, this is called cam and this is follower, the angle rotated by this cam to move this follower from the least position to highest position is called rise. And this follower will be at highest position for some time, so that period will called dwell. And after that it will come down from the highest position to the least position, that is called fall. And after that we will have one more dwell, so that is not no need to consider one more dwell to get the cam profile. Just rise, one rise, dwell, fall is sufficient. So after representing this, so this is a rise, dwell, and this is fall. Here we can see this gap is a rise, dwell, and this will be the fall, rise, dwell, and fall. After that divide this rise and fall into same number of equal parts. Suppose here first of all let us complete here the rectangle. So we can complete the rectangle by the stroke. Same here we have represented 40 mm, so here also represent 40 mm, and complete this rectangle. So that will be like this. After that divide this rise and fall into same number of equal parts. And just remember, for drawing this uniform acceleration and retardation, we have to represent this rise and fall into same number of equal even parts. Means suppose 4 parts we have to divide, or 6 parts we have to take, like that. But don't take odd numbers, that is 5, like 3, like that. So why? Because we'll see here. So I told just divide into equal parts, means 6 centimeters means I can divide into 6 equal parts, that is 6 is the even number, and equal parts means total is 6 centimeters. So you'll get each part as 1 centimeter. And for the other cases, for other values, just you can calculate the distance and divide it by this total even parts that you want to make it. Suppose if you want to make it 4 parts, measure this distance divided by 4. Each distance something you will get, take that much of divisions and you divide. You can divide. So just remember, you have to do equal even parts. So this will be 6 parts, 6 divisions. So I am making. And here also, so just no need to divide into the dwell, and just divide this fall also the same number of equal even parts. Just remember, it is even parts for the uniform acceleration and retardation. So just like this. So give the here numbering 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here it will be 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and this is 0. So you have to give the numbering like this only. After that, divide this also into the same number of equal parts. And also here, just divide this stroke also into same number of equal parts, that is 6. Suppose do like this, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. So total measure the total distance and divide it by 6, make it 6 equal parts, because you have done this rise and fall, 6 equal parts. And after that, just draw the lines. After that, here just from this corner to from this zero corner to this first of all, select the middle line, select the middle line, and from this corner zero to this first on the middle line you take the first corner, that is this point, and just join that from this zero corner to the first corner on the middle line, because it is 6 parts, means third line is the middle line. On that, take the first point and join this zero and first corner. So where this line will meet on the line number 1, that is point A, and after that join the second point on the middle line, that is 3, to this 0. And this line, where it cuts on the line number 2, is point B. And after that, join this 0 with this third point on the middle line, that is 3. So this one. And this is the line number 3, and this is the line number 3, this is cutting here, so it is the C, point C. And repeat the procedure from this corner, opposite corner to this 0. So here, this, so from here, so when you draw a line to this C, so that will be the same point, common point. C is the common point, and this is point number 3, and go to this point number 4 on the middle line, that is 3 line. So from this corner, join this point number 4, and where it is cutting on this line number 4, because it's the line number 4 and this is the line number 4 in the vertical direction, so where this cuts, that is the point number D. And next, join this fifth point on this middle line to this corner. So where it cuts on the line number 5 is called E, and this point is F, and the opposite point F dash here. So repeat this procedure to the other side also like this. Select the middle line here. This is the corner first point on the middle line. Join this first point to this corner. So where it cuts, that is A dash, and this 0 to this second point on this middle line 3, so that will be B dash. So this is second line, so this will be B dash, and this one point 3 on this middle line, join this with corner point O, so that will be C dash, this one C dash. And also repeat this procedure from this F, so that is from this line C dash, and this is third point. Go to the fourth point on the middle line, join this with this F dash corner. So where it cuts on the line number 4 dash, so that will be D dash, and go for the fifth point on this middle line, join with this F dash corner. So while drawing this, where it cuts on the line number 5, so that is E dash, and this is F dash already we got. So now join all these points with us freehand only, and start from this corner O, join these points freehand, smooth curve A B C D E F F dash, E dash, E dash, C dash, B dash, A dash, O dash. And just once again highlight these points A, B, C, D, E, F, F dash, E dash. And so this is called displacement diagram. This is called displacement diagram. And from here, after this, least radius of cam rotation is given 25 mm. So from that least radius, first draw a circle, locate the center, and just draw a center line. And here the maximum cases, the condition will be axis of the follower is passing through the axis of the cam. Means here you can draw a follower. For example, it is a knife edge follower. Suppose it is given, you can assume like that. So it is a circle of radius 25 mm least radius, and after that just indicate these angles 120, 30 and 120 here. Suppose start from here, it is 0. Start from here 90 and 120 means like this, and after that 30, after that 120 to represent a fall. And just divide these angles, rise, dwell and fall, into same number of equal parts which you have done here. So this will be 120 degrees means 6 parts, means each 20 degrees you will get. Just do that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash. Same here also, you just leave this dwell, and this is also 120 by 6 parts, so each 20 degrees you will get. Do that 2 dash, 1 dash, and this will be the 0. So from all those lines, just draw lines from those points to the center of the circle from the divisions. Just draw the lines from all those division points, center to this 4 dash, center to this 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 is anyway it is there. And after that, so measure ground 2A with compass, and just take that length and cut
on this line number 1, so that is A, and measure 2 to B, take with compass. So take the same length, put on compass 2 and cut the line number B, and follow that procedure, repeat that procedure. Measure 3 to C, take compass, put compass on 3, cut C, D, repeat that procedure. E, F, F dash, E dash, D dash, C dash, sorry, this F dash, E dash, D dash, C dash, and on the two number B dash, 1, A dash, and this is 0. And with the free hand only, just join A, B, C, D, E, F, F dash, E dash, D dash, C dash, B dash, A dash, and 0. And this remaining portion. So this will be the cam profile, this outline from 0 to A, B, C, D, E, F, C, F dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, B dash, A dash, and 0. And this remaining portion, this is called the cam profile. Thank you. And for more videos, please subscribe and like it, share it. Thank you.